and gentlemen, the following feature confrontation. It is for the World Television Championship. It is set for one fall. Introducing first the challenger from Glens Falls, New York, weighing 287 pounds, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
Well, comments from Vader and Flair as they are prepared for the strap match. That is going to be wild.
I don't know how you prepare yourself for a strap match.
Just prepare yourself for a beating, that's all. Have you ever had a beating?
And well, ladies and gentlemen, his opponent in this title event, to be accompanied by the greatest promoter on the face of the earth, Colonel Robert Parker from Minnesota, weighing 248 pounds, the World Television Champion, the Enforcer, Arn Anderson.
Well, Hacksaw Jim Duggan with another shot of becoming the television champ, but, you know, he faced Arn Anderson about a month ago, maybe 2 months ago here on this program, but there's been something added to the pot, so to speak, and that's those 1,000 gold coins to the man who defeats Arn Anderson. It could go to Hacksaw Jim Duggan if he wins here this week.
What would he do with all that money? What would he possibly do with that?
Maybe he would run for office, like you plan to do. Tell me some of the changes you would make if you would be president of the United States.
There's a lot of things I'd do, especially with the White House. I have it painted.
You mean the outside?
The outside, yes.
Oh, yeah, okay. You mean another coat of white paint?
No. I'd have all those signs on there, Bobby Heenan t-shirts here. And, you know, I'd hawk more merchandise. That's what I'd do.
There's the television title belt. All right, let's also remind the fans that coming up in Uncensored, boxer versus wrestler, Johnny B. Babb will have the boxing gloves on against Arn Anderson. And Hacksaw Jim Duggan has agreed to a martial arts match with a man that we saw in unveiling last week, Ming.
That to me is Uncensored. That this man would even think that he could get by a man like Ming in a martial arts match, let alone any other kind of a match. Shows you how dumb this Duggan is. But he's lucky enough where he could walk away television champion now.
From the neutral position, side headlock, Colonel Parker has removed Ming from the bodyguard ringside position to a lethal martial arts expert wrestler in the ring. And of course, I understand he's just like a cage animal as Ming. Wants to get in the ring every chance he gets.
Well, you know, it's been a while since he's been in the ring. And, you know, I know a lot about this man when he wrestled before. But Colonel didn't want him to wrestle. He said, I'm going to wait till he's ready, till he's right, the right occasion. Well, this is the right occasion. And he must be ready.
Duggan stops the foot, wheels around, double A, picks him up. Atomic drop to the ropes and on the outside.
Now see, Duggan tries to take a cheap shot here. Going after the colonel.
No, I think maybe he was just chasing the colonel for a couple of steps, but his end result was Arn Anderson, who he put on his backside with that big clothesline.
You don't really think he can think that far ahead, do you? I don't want to see that far ahead.
Absolutely, as a former United States heavyweight champion.
Couldn't figure the guy was behind him.
Rolls double A in. Duggan, forearm shot. Down goes double A.
He's your blue-collar champion, all right.
He really is. Right now, could be, at the end of this match, $1,000-plus richer. Remember, that's 1,000 gold coins. One, two.
How much each of those gold coins worth?
I don't know what the going rate is.
Could somebody find me that number?
What number?
How much is in that jar?
Why do you want to know?
I just like to know those things. My hobby, coins.
Coins is your hobby?
And cash.
I'm sure it is. Do you ever spend anything?
If I was to stop people from buying me things, you know what an insult that would be to them?
A pickup.
Oh!
The only way you'd spend money if it was the taxpayers' money. One, two, got a two count.
I do so many charitable things, that's why I don't have a whole lot of money.
Yeah. The back of the neck. Duggan, reverse chin lock.
I'll tell you something, he's got a lot of money. That's that Arn Anderson right there, because he's your television champion. 1,000 gold coins.
Wow. extra incentive, and of course, a little, as the Colonel has said before, a carrot.
There could be $25,000 in that cookie jar.
Yes, it could.
Could be more.
Yes, it could.
I'm not needed here with you like I thought. I should. There should be security there. I should guard it.
We got Doug Dellinger.
Who's watching him?
I can't answer that one. Maybe David Crockett is. I don't know. Or Eric Bischoff. Well, Eric can now. He's in Japan again. Right now, though, Arn Anderson is starting to mount some offense against the former U.S. champ. And Arn Anderson, a man who can really assault you. And that's exactly what he's doing here to Duggan.
And Duggan's a funny kind of a wrestler. You can beat on him a long time and think you have him. But all of a sudden, he hears this chant of USA, and it's like you pull the stake from his heart.
The chokehold, and there's a warning from Nick Patrick. The fans are trying to encourage and get the momentum flowing back into Hacksaw Jim Duggan here by the USA chant.
Did he?
May be working.
Maybe they should yell Sweden and really throw him off.
Sweden. Up and down. Duggan is going for the, well, I thought maybe the three-point stand. There's the clothesline.
Arn's too close to the ropes. He moved himself. He knows exactly where he's at.
Slams him down, and here he comes. Right at the base of his 2x4, Duggan. He's got it.
Oh, I don't like the look of this.
One, two.
Now his foot's on the rope.
No, Colonel, put it on there.
His foot's on the rope.
The Colonel put the foot on there.
I didn't say he did or didn't. I said his foot's on the rope.
Well, nevertheless, uh-oh. He is going to chase the Colonel around. Ducking Arn Anderson, the sleeper hold. The sleeper on Arn Anderson.
Is the match still going on?
Yeah, yes it is. Wait a minute, here comes Bing. Oh my. He broke that 2x4 and retained it in.
Did you see that?
Ming, a one-man assault team, had come in, apparently because of the chasing of Colonel Parker. Immediately dug in, saw it coming in, took the board, and didn't even faze him.
And Duggan's not smart enough to realize he almost got turned inside out. He gave Ming his best shot.
Look at this.
Duggan's your winner by the throat.
You heard it, ladies and gentlemen.
Look at Duggan's eyes.
Winner of the match. As a result of a disqualification, Hacksaw Jim Duggan.
We need to see that again, Brain, because that 2x4 is an illegal weapon. You need facing. And now they got to collide in a martial arts match and uncensored. How can you hurt this guy?
He never even blinked. I'm not going to say nothing. Just watch. Run for your lives!
And we'll be back. Wow!